Do you want to shoot videos of yourself? Maybe you're shooting YouTube videos or tutorials and you're wondering, can I shoot these videos on my phone? The answer is yes. Shooting high quality videos on your phone is possible. However, it can be difficult, especially if you're a beginner. You have to ensure that the camera settings are correct, you're capturing good audio, the framing is right, you're not being cut off in the video. All of that and more, all while also being in front of the camera. That's why in today's video, we're gonna take you through 7 tips to help you capture the best possible videos of yourself on your smartphone. I'm Teresa with NVIDIA, and today we're talking all about filming yourself. Let's get started. Let's start with the first tip, which is to make sure you're using the right camera on your phone. So on a typical smartphone, you have 2 cameras, the front-facing camera or the selfie camera, and then the back camera. The selfie camera has the one benefit of allowing you to see yourself while you record, but that's pretty much where the benefits stop. The back-facing camera is always going to be higher quality. The only time I would really recommend using the front-facing selfie camera is if you need just a really quick shot of yourself. Maybe you're out and about capturing a vlog, and you don't have time to go through the rest of the tips that we're gonna get to in this video, you could always get just a really quick shot using the selfie camera. But in general, you're gonna wanna opt for the back-facing camera to get better quality. The challenge then is being able to see what you're filming. This is actually really important. You wanna be able to monitor your video to make sure it's in focus and to make sure it's recording when you need it to be. Take it from me, I have had my videos stop recording in the middle and I kept talking for a long while thinking the video was still going, only to find out that it wasn't later on. Your video might stop recording if your phone runs out of space or something like that. There are a lot of technical issues that can happen, so it's always good to monitor your video. There are a few different ways to get around this. The first and simplest way is to use a mirror. This is old school, but it works perfectly well. It's also a great option because chances are you already have a mirror lying around somewhere. So all you have to do is position the mirror behind your phone. You'll want to angle it upwards a little bit or slant it sideways a little bit, and that will allow you to see the reflection of your phone's screen. The next option would be to mirror your phone's screen to your laptop or your computer. So this is going to be different depending on the type of phone you have and the type of computer you have. If you have both an iPhone and a Mac computer, you'll be able to connect them using the Lightning cable, and then you'll be able to open QuickTime on your computer, go to record new movie, and then select your iPhone. So basically you're turning your phone into a webcam, so that will allow you to see what your phone screen is recording. And then if you have a Windows computer and an Android phone, there's an app called Kinect that can allow you to view your phone's screen if your phone and laptop are both signed into the same Wi-Fi network. If you have a tablet or an iPad or a Chromebook or some other type of mobile device, then you can download a screen sharing app. And if you download the same app to both your device and your phone, then you would be able to screencast between the two. So that would be an option. And if you're not able to use any of those methods because of the type of equipment you have, you can download a software called Reflector. This is a screen sharing software that will work no matter what kind of phone or computer you have. So it's a great option if you don't want to have to worry about that. It is going to cost you a little bit of money. You can go ahead and find a link to that in the description below. So any of these options will work. The important thing is to monitor your video as you're recording, just to make sure the video is going and everything you need to be in focus is in focus. But also, when it comes to monitoring your video, you want to make sure that you're always looking into the camera while you're talking. So finish the sentence, then check on your monitor, and then look back into the camera to start talking again. It's very noticeable and pretty distracting if you're looking slightly away from the camera while you're talking. Your next tip is to use a tripod for still shots and a gimbal for shots that involve movement instead of shooting handheld. You can get a great tripod for your phone for about $20, and that's really all you need for this type of video. You don't need anything too fancy. Again, you can find a link to a phone tripod in the description. And then if you're gonna be filming any moving shots, you definitely want to get a gimbal for your phone. This will make a world of a difference between shaky handheld footage. It will really make your footage look a lot more smooth and a lot more cinematic. If you're just filming talking videos similar to this one, you might not need to worry about getting a gimbal because it's just gonna be still footage. But if you're gonna be filming B-roll or if you're gonna be filming vlogs that have a moving camera, you definitely wanna look into getting a gimbal to stabilize your footage. The Hohem 3-axis gimbal is a great option for a mix of affordability and function. Again, you can find the link to that in the description. Tip number 3 is to make sure you get your video composition right. The first thing you wanna think about is the orientation of your shot. Are you gonna be filming in portrait or landscape? If your video is going to be going on YouTube, you're going to want to film it horizontally or landscape mode. And if it's going on TikTok or Instagram, you're going to want to film it vertically or portrait. And if you're not sure where it's going to go, what I usually do is film it horizontally, but leave enough space to crop it in later if I need to. So basically, you need to get a pretty wide horizontal shot. You also want to think about headspace when you're composing a shot. So you always want to leave a little bit of space between the top of your head and the top of the frame, and you want to make sure the top of your head is never being cut off at all. It's actually a pretty easy mistake to make. But you also want to make sure there's not too much space. You can pretty much just eyeball this one and see what looks good. And you want to make sure that your phone is level with your face. You don't really want to shoot from above or from below at all. So this is where your tripod comes in handy to make your life a lot easier. You can just make those small adjustments to make sure that your face is right level with your phone. Next, you want to set up your background. So for a video like this where you're just talking to the camera, it's always a good idea to put some visual intrigue in the background. So you're going to want to steer clear of blank walls. However, you also don't want to have too much in the background because then it just ends up looking distracting. So I have just a few things behind me, as you can see, like a lamp and a computer screen. These are all pretty big objects. You want to steer clear of having a lot of small objects and instead go with a few bigger objects. You also want to make sure there's a lot of depth to the shot, so pull your chair as far away from the wall as you can. All right, the fourth tip is to use manual camera settings. So every phone comes with a built-in camera app, but that app doesn't usually give you a lot of control over your focus, your shutter speed, your aperture, your ISO, and all those things that you could control on an actual camera. So what you're going to want to do is download an app. There are a lot of apps available in any app store that will allow you to access those settings on your phone's camera. Really, any of these apps that say pro camera or manual mode or something like that should work. And then go into your app of choice, and you're going to want to set your frame rate to 24 frames per second and your shutter speed to 1/50. That's kind of the standard for video. You want your ISO to be as low as you can possibly make it while still having a nice, well-lit shot. The higher your ISO, the grainier your image is gonna be, but ISO is a good option if you don't have a ton of light available. When it comes to focus, most phones are actually pretty good at autofocus, especially if they have a face that they can recognize. So autofocus is a pretty good option if you're recording yourself. However, if you wanna just really make sure that the focus isn't gonna change in the middle of the video, you're gonna wanna set that to manual. So then to set your focus, you'll need to have some object in the spot where you're gonna go, maybe a pillow or something like that, and then just tap the screen to focus on that and then lock that focus in. Then when you sit down in the chair, the focus should stay the same and you should be in focus. The next tip is to make sure you're properly lighting your videos. Most smartphones today come with very powerful high-quality cameras. But if you don't have good lighting in your videos, even with those high quality cameras, you're not gonna get those professional looking shots. The simplest method for lighting is to use natural light. So if you're gonna shoot outdoors, you can shoot at golden hour, which is the hour before sunset, or right after sunrise. That's when the sun provides the most ideal lighting for videos. It's a nice soft light as opposed to the harsh sunlight that you might get if you shot closer to noon. And then if you're shooting indoors, you basically can just set up in front of a window. This is a great option because it's free. However, there are a lot of downsides. It's unreliable, it changes all the time, and you might not have a ton of it available to you, especially if you live in an apartment with only one window like I do. So I would recommend picking up a few LED video lights. The standard guide for artificial lighting is to use a three-point setup. So you have a key light, which is your main source of light, and you're gonna position that just a little bit to the side of your face so that it hits your face on a bit of an angle. And then you have a fill light on the other side, which just kind of fills in some of the shadows on your face. And then you have a backlight or a hair light behind you, which kind of makes you pop from the background by giving you a bit of a halo effect. So you can find the link in the description to get the LED light that I have, which works great as both a key and a fill light. You can adjust the brightness so you can make the key light brighter and the fill light softer. And then for a backlight, you can even get away with something smaller. So you can find a link in the description to a really tiny LED light, which will work great as a backlight. All right, the next tip I have is to make sure you're capturing high quality audio. So what you don't want to do under any circumstances is use the built-in mic on your phone. If you have really bad audio quality, that's actually gonna make your video look a lot more unprofessional than if you had bad video quality. So one of the easiest and most straightforward options, which is the option that I recommend, is to use a lavalier mic. This isn't the only way to capture audio. A lot of people use shotgun mics, But in my experience, using a lavalier mic is the easiest and most foolproof way to record your audio for a talking video. I think they work great for any setting. They're great for a talking video like this one. They're also great for vlogs because then you ensure that the microphone is always really close to your face and capturing even audio levels. Again, shotgun mics are definitely a possibility, but then you run into the issue of changing audio levels if you're moving around a lot, and the issue of not really picking up the audio very well if you're far away from the mic. Lavalier mics are also very affordable. I use one that I got for $13, which I'm using right now, and as you can hear, the audio quality is very good. You can find a link to that in the description. So you can go ahead and plug the mic right into your phone, and then you'll have the audio and video all in one file. The only downside to this is then you have the wire in between you and your phone, and that might be a little bit constricting because then you can only be as far away from your phone as the length of the wire. So if you don't want to have to worry about that, what you could do is record the audio on a laptop or tablet or an audio recorder if you happen to have one of those lying around. So plug your mic into there, and then in that case what you're going to do is start your video recording, then start your audio recording, and then you're going to clap at the beginning of your video. So then when you go to edit, you can sync up the audio and video by matching up the spike on the waveform where you clapped. All right, that brings us to our last tip, which is to make sure you record enough B-roll. Whether you're filming a tutorial or a vlog, having B-roll is a great way to visualize what you're saying. And it also just makes your video a lot more interesting to watch by breaking up the monotony of having just one single shot. So when it comes to tutorial, you want to make a list of just anything that would be easier to understand if there's a visual to go along with the explanation, and then film all of that B-roll. And then when it comes to a vlog, you can really just shoot anything that's interesting to you and anything that adds to the story of the video. We also have another video on our channel that goes a lot more in depth about shooting cinematic footage with your smartphone. So you can go ahead and check that out if you want to learn more about shooting B-roll. And that was our roundup of our top 7 tips to help you record high quality videos of yourself using your smartphone. Were any of these tips a complete surprise to you, or did you know all of them already? Let us know in the comments below. We would love your feedback because we would love to know how we can make videos that are the most helpful to you. Don't forget to check out this video to dive deeper into mobile videography. I'm Teresa with InVideo, and I will see you in the next one.